All right, so round five, we're 3-1, so looking pretty good. Since there's 34 people that joined the event, it's going to be 6 rounds. So we need to win this one pretty much to make top 8. Well, be secure, so we have better tiebreakers, because if we lose next round, then our tiebreakers will be better, and it'll give us a better chance of making top 8 if we lose. So... yeah, so our opponent chooses to play first, keep their hand, we'll keep our hand. We don't have a green, but, we'll hopefully top deck, but, he plays Inquisition, and, takes our birds, which is fine because we don't have a green source right now, so we're not too worried, but we top a Terramorphic Expanse, so that's good for us. So our opponent plays Quest for the Graveyard. He's playing Mono Black Vampires. Plays Myers Toll. So what we'll do here is reveal our Ranger and Lightning Bolt, since those are the two cards that we don't care about right now. So yeah, he takes the Bolt because he doesn't want any removal. And we'll fetch a Forest. So we'll go fetch ourselves a Plains and lay down a Pride Mage here. Or the Mystic, yeah, that's probably the best idea. So, grab our sledge, so we can pump up our guys some more and start gaining some life. But our opponent plays Vampire Aristocrat, so the guy gets pretty annoying, just basically a vampire husk, and he'll pass the turn. Sorry about rushing through these videos so fast, guys. I am really tired right now. This premiere events take quite some time, and I'm trying to get all the replays done before they disappear. So excuse the rushed out videos. So we'll play our Hierarch and pass the turn. We could have attacked, but yeah, he plays Blade of the Blood Chief, which is going to be really annoying. So my original plan was not to attack with him and then activate the ability and play a sledge at the end of our opponent's turn. So yeah, he plays Blade of the Blood Chief on the Aristocrat, and we'll just take the damage because we don't want his guy to grow insanely huge, and we'll sack our Mista and fetch a mountain, and we'll use the Stoneforge Mystic's ability to put our sledge into play. So things still looking good for us. We get a Garruk here, but I think Pride Mage is the best, so we can, if he has anything that would kill our guys, we can shoot the Blade of the Blood Chief. But so I'll attack with the double exalted, pump up our guy up to the 3-4, get in some damage, and pass the turn. Our opponent plays Consuming Vapors. So right here, what I should have done is probably use the Pride Mage's ability to shoot Blade of the Blood Chief, so his guy doesn't get ridiculously huge. But I decide I didn't want to lose all my creatures and wipe away my board. So we got rid of the Mystic since it was the least relevant card, and his vampire just starts getting big, and he gets a counter for a Quest for the Graveyard Lord. Sorry, I'm slurring my words so much. So he attacks with the Aristocrat, and we'll just take it here. So Sun Petal Grove, which is good for us. We'll play Garruk. Untap two lands here, and equip our Pride Mage with the sledge here, and get in for 5 damage. Oh, 6 damage, my bad. Gain 6 life, so we can start to race. He'll probably attack our Garruk next turn, which was what I was hoping for. I wanted him to attack him so that way we could catch up on life and race him that way. So Consuming Vapors, We're going to get rid of our Hierarch. And he gets to put two more counters on his Aristocrat. So it becomes a 6-6, and he gets another counter on his quest. So he plays a Vampire Hexmage and ends up killing our Garruk that way. And now his Vampire is an 8-8, and he has enough counters on his quest for the Grave Lord to put a 5-5 zombie token into play whenever he chooses. So swings in for 8, takes us down to 10. Right here, I decide the best thing to do was a swing in for 5, try to get him to use his Grave Lord and kill his zombie token and gain 5 life, even though his gal get huge. So I go use the Ranger of Eos here, and I go and fetch a Dragon Master Outcast. So we can get, if we get one more land, then I can start making tokens each turn that can block the vampire. And just a scoop mob to try to get a guy out that can erase his vampire. So we'll swing in with the Pride Mage here. He'll block with the Zombie Giant. And his guy will get insanely huge here, so he'll become a 12-12. We'll use the Ranger here as a blocker, because we don't want him to sacrifice the Highborn. Because if we don't block, he'll sacrifice. He'll use the Aristocrat's ability to pump him up to 14-14. Use the ability to drain us for 2 life and gain 2 life, and that will kill us. So we have to block with the Ranger regardless. So that's fine. We'll do that. We get a mountain. We don't get the 6th land, so Dragon Master Outcast isn't the solution for us, but we get our Elspeth here. So we can start just laying tokens into play. We'll drop our scoop mob and start making them big, and we'll just start making 1-1 tokens to block the vampire. So he attacks with everyone. We'll let the Highborn get through, and we'll block the Aristocrat with the soldier token here. And yeah, so his guy's a 16-16 now. And he plays Mind Sludge, so that gets rid of our Dragon Master Outcast. So that gets rid of that plan for us. So at this point, our Scoop Mob starts getting counters on, so he's a 5-5 right now. So we get Marshall's Anthem, and I could play it, but I want to hold out for the last mana so we can kick it and return one of our creatures from our graveyard to play. So what I'll do here is put in a 1-1 soldier token and equip the scoop mob with the sledge and get in for that's right, because I don't want the Highborn to get in, have him sack it and kill our Elspeth, because I want the Elspeth to stay into play. So what we'll do, we'll block the soldier token on the Aristocrat and the scoop mob on the Highborn. So he uses the Aristocrat's ability to sacrifice the Highborn so I don't gain any life. Pumps up his vampire even more than it was already. Uses the ability to shoot for 2 life. He drains us for 2 life and doesn't bother taking the damage for the Elspeth. So he has a 22 right now. So the guy Blade of the Blood Chief is pretty insane, but our Scoop Mob gets another 4 counters on him, so we have an 11-11 right now. And what we'll do here is we'll put a token into play and play an Escort just in case he draws some kind of mass removal spell for our side of the board, and that way we can keep our guys alive. So I'll swing in for 11 here and gain 11 life. So for a while there, wasn't sure we were going to pull through, but we ended up winning game one. So let's go to game two now. Alright, so he chooses to play first and keeps his hand, and we will also keep our hand. Tectonic Edge doesn't do any good here, but we got our Knight of the Reliquary, we got O-Ring, and Vengevine, we got Wildwood if we need to bring out a Manland for any reason, so the hand seems pretty good, so we'll lead off with the Wildwoods and pass. We'll play our Panorama here, so we can sacrifice it and go find ourselves a basic land. Yep, that's what we'll do. We'll go get ourselves a forest, since we have plains and a mountain we can search for. So he has a Vampire Nighthawk. The guy's good. Right here, I believe... Okay, this was my idea. We'll throw down the Thopter. We'll take 2 damage. He'll gain 2 life. We can throw down... If he doesn't have any creature, we can attack with the Thopter and Vengevine. And eventually just... O-ring his guy when he keeps him back as a blocker, so seemed like a good idea to me. Attacks, can't do anything since he's flying, but we top deck a lightning bolt, which is good for us. And yeah, we'll hold back on the Vengevine here, and we'll play the Knight of the Reliquary, I think, and keep lightning bolt mana open. So, plays Hideous End and destroys our creature. We lose 2 life. So, our opponent should be feeling pretty good here, but we'll play our Knight. So, he's a 5/5 now because we have the 3 lands in our graveyard. We're just going to see if he chooses to attack or not. So, it plays the Hex Mage. Attacks, so we'll Lightning Bolt his Nighthawk and get rid of it. So yeah, come on, let's go replace. So we get Sunpetalgrove, we'll lay down a Vengevine, and we'll attack for 9. Our opponent takes it, so they're down to 13. So Myers Toll, he's obviously going to take the Oblivion Ring, which is fine for us. Doesn't either has removal or he doesn't have much of anything. So we'll play the Basilisk Caller, equip it under our Vengevine, since this is the guy that we're at least worried about losing, since he can just we can bring him back if we get more guys. So we attack with everyone, but he plays Urge to Feed, making our Knight a 2/2. And makes his Vampire a 3/2 first striker. So we're going to lose our guy. I was debating whether or not to attack with him in the first place. Well, her, whatever. And using the ability to get more lands into play. And then we could attack with the Wildwood. But I thought the damage route would be better. But, you know, we took our chances and we lost. It happens. It's part of the game. But, so Vengevine gets in. For 4 damage, and we gain 4 life, so still not too worried. We just can't attack with him anymore because of the Hex Mage. So, Bloodthrown Vampire, just a smaller version of the Husk or the Aristocrat. So, our turn comes. We play the Sanctuary, we activate the Wildwood since he can't first strike it. We'll equip the Basilisk Caller on it, get in some extra damage, try to gain some life. So we're not too worried here. Dresses us, but he should have known we had Tectonic Edge. Obviously, he wasn't paying attention because he's seen this, I believe, 3 times now. So he should know it's in our hand since we haven't played it yet. So that's just bad play there. Yeah, we're just gonna do the Wildwood. I was thinking play Cobra, but there's no point in playing the Cobra right now, really. So get in for 3 more damage with our Wildwood here. Chooses not to block, so he's down to 3. And he plays Vampire Lacerator. Why he played Vampire Lacerator, I'm not sure. Sure, he can sacrifice the Blood Throne, but we're just gonna... We have 24 life, so we're not worried about that. He's gonna be losing 1 life each turn that it's in play, so... yeah. We'll play our Lotus Cobra and Steward of Velron. And we're just going to equip our collar and yeah, pass the turn. He gets down to 2 life, takes the damage from the Lacerator. Plays Marsh Casualty, so Oliver could just get -2/-2, so he pretty much clears the board except for the Vengevine. Doesn't attack. So yeah, we get our Johnny, and we're going to use his ability to shoot our opponent for 3 and gain 3 life, and that should be game. So yeah, there's round 5. So we're 4-1 going into the last round. Pretty sure if we win or lose here, if we win, we're definitely in top 8, but if we lose, we need good tiebreakers to make the finals. So yeah, we'll see you in round 6.